giant blast and barely a turbulent.
It was robust. I mean, I'm scared. I'm just kind of like, whatever. We're going to go through the lasers. Oh, and they missed the robots. Not one person got a shot on the robot.
Why are you breathing so hard? So I can live. What kind of...
Hi, guys. It's Mother's Day. Oh, wait. I should have put on my Star Wars shirt. Oh, well.
You have a Star Wars shirt?
Yeah.
You're a bigger dork than me.
I got it from H&M. It was cute.
From what?
H&M. It was cute.
Do you have a filter on?
I am using a third-party app. So, yes, I have a filter on.
You're not filtering me?
Yeah, you're filtered. Hi, guys.
I look bad even filtered.
Forcing Mark to watch Star Wars with me because I've never seen it. No, I'm not forcing him to watch Star Wars. He wanted to watch Star Wars. And then, does my face look too white?
Mm-hmm. That's why I ask if you had an app.
Okay, new filter. Well, no filter. And I have these crazy big eyelashes on because my eye is super swollen from allergies and then an eye infection. Don't touch it.
Morgan, I would never.
And I don't want to use any good eyelashes because I'm going to have to throw these eyelashes away. So I put on these big, giant eyelashes that look freaking crazy. But what are you going to do? Okay, I didn't force him to watch Star Wars. I said I wanted to watch Star Wars for Mother's Day because I've never seen it. I don't know why I'm doing with my hands. Then I decided I wanted to do a movie review of it.
That's what you're forcing
him to do. And that's what I'm forcing him to do.
Super happy.
Because he didn't want to do it. But it's Mother's Day. Aww. Okay, we're gonna watch Star Wars. I mean, like, I've seen bits and pieces of it, but never the whole thing.
The only good one of those movies was Spaceballs.
Maybe it'll help somebody out there in the YouTube-verse. Is that a thing? I don't know. This is super dumb.
Let's get it on.
Okay. We're gonna start watching. This is not the beginning, I don't think. Wait, stop. Stop doing that. Gotta rewind it, because we started. How do you do this?
Babe, let me have it. I need to do a video on how to show you how to use a remote control.
Time ago in a galaxy far, far away. That part is cool because you always think it's supposed to be in the future, but it's not. It's a long time ago. And this first opening scene with the words that are kind of on a slant always made me hate the movie right off the bat because I can never read the words quickly enough. And even if I do read the words quickly enough, like I'm trying to read really fast and then I don't ever understand what it means. So wait, can you rewind it? I was talking. Oh no.
You remember that Barney song? It's like, this is a song that never ends. It's gonna be this video.
A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. Star Wars. Episode 4. Already confusing. And they use Roman numerals, which as a kid, it's like, I'm already confused. You know what I'm saying? A New Hope. It is a period of civil war. Rebel spaceships striking from a hidden base have won their first victory against the evil Galactic Empire. Wait, so what does that mean? What is it? They're in war.
War? Okay, so you got that part figured out. That's good.
Wait, Rebel spaceships striking from a hidden... Wait, pause it. So apparently there's an evil Galactic Empire. When I was a kid, I always thought rebels meant bad, but actually in this movie, it means good. It's like Michael Scott, where negative actually means a good thing.
Apparently in the medicine community, negative means good, which makes absolutely no sense.
So, hold on. The little group won a victory against the big evil group. It's like the Revolutionary War. Revolutionary War? Yeah, Revolutionary War.
They say in this movie the force is strong with this one. I would say reading comprehension is strong with this one.
I'm not good at reading comprehension. Even the kids are better at it than I am. I've said that before. I'm a slow reader. I can't comprehend that quickly.
During the battle,
rebel spies managed to steal a secret plan to the Empire's ultimate weapon, the Death Star. So during the battle, the good guys stole secret plans to a weapon, and this weapon is powerful enough to destroy an entire planet. That is scary if you really think about it. Think if like somebody had a weapon that could destroy Earth.
Pursued by the Empire's sinister agents, Princess Leia races home aboard her starship.
The bad guys are chasing Princess Leia aboard her starship, whatever that is.
Spaceship.
They say, no, it's a starship. They expect us to know what a starship is. Mm-hmm. That's another mistake.
Custodian of the stolen plans.
Hey guys, you need to know here that custodian means somebody that has custody of the plans, not a janitor. I was like, why are they bringing a janitor into this?
Reading comprehension skill level 10.
Go ahead. Wait, I forget what that meant.
Why don't you explain this to me like I am an 8-year-old?
Okay, so these good guys and bad guys are fighting in a random galaxy that we don't even know about. It's far, far away, and it was a long time ago. I mean, who even knows if it still exists? But anyway, good news. The good guys just stole the bad guys' evil plans. Plans to a weapon that can blow up entire planets. So now this girl, Princess Leia, has the plans in her starship. If she can make it home, she will save everyone in the galaxy. But the bad guys are chasing her and trying to get the plans back. Who knows why they didn't make 2 copies of the plans? Not me. Maybe they didn't have a ton of ink back then? Also, bad guys are usually kind of dumb.
She has the plan to restore freedom to the galaxy.
How?
Stay tuned to find out. Okay, here comes some sort of, I don't know, then the big one.
So even on the small screen, this does seem super impressive. Just how the ship keeps going and going looks massive. I'm sure it was super duper cool back then when they didn't have all the special effects that we have, when special effects were new and people weren't used to seeing them all the time, because it's even impressive now. I've got to admit, the entire beginning of this movie is super cool. Just like the pow in the intro, the slanted word crawl preface, and then the soundtrack. I mean, the fade up to the planets, the ship. Yeah, it's cool. I get it. Kind of makes your heart race just a little bit. Oh my goodness. I think I'm going over to the dark side.
Here comes some sort of... And then the other big one.
Two ships.
Two spaceships.
Starships.
Star spaceships. We have yet to find out what a starship is because we've only watched 10 seconds.
The big one is the Empire. They get all the big, good equipment. And the Rebels got the janky old stuff.
It looks like it's going pretty fast, though. The other one looks like
so
it's going
the
slower.
Big one that the Empire has is called a Destroyer. So they're shooting it, I would assume, Princess Leia. They just said, opening thing we just spent 10 minutes on reading, that she's fleeing back to her home planet being pursued. So,
you also have to be, like, beyond reading comprehension, you have to also have to be able to make connections. Connect the dots when you're watching these movies. I don't know if I'm great at that either.
Apparently the geek is stronger in me than you.
Shooting. I thought the green things were supposed to be good, but apparently you can shoot green ones and they're bad. Okay, here are the robots. And, okay, these soldiers coming in, you said those were rebels. Their spacesuits don't look very good.
They don't have much money.
Like, they just have a shell helmet.
Like a turtle-looking thing.
And why are these robots just on the loose?
Because those are interpreters. They're like human something robots.
I do like the all-white interior of the ships, though. That's a good call.
Super chic.
Okay, giant blast and barely a turbulent.
They're sucking the ship into the big ship.
Yeah, yeah. Do a close-up on the one guy with the crooked helmet.
The big spaceship looks pretty cool. I like the color. I would decorate with that. Those suits are not going to protect them from anything. They're just wearing vests. That's it. Big explosion.
Nope, I was wrong. They're all fine.
Oh, stormtroopers.
Now, those suits are good. Except it still doesn't seem like those suits are protecting them from those little lasers.
Mm-mm.
So why are they even wearing them? That's the question.
It makes them feel better about
everybody's
themselves.
Everybody's like, everybody's dramatically dying.
I think those are all clones of the same guy, if I remember right.
Seems like they would have a better, like they would do things together better. Like, those robots don't even seem scared. They're just kind of like, whatever, we're gonna go through the lasers. Oh, and they missed the robots. Not one person got a shot on the robot.
Stormtroopers are like notoriously bad shots.
They killed all this. I told you those suits would do nothing, first of all, and they killed all the rebels.
Here
it's a sad day. It's a sad day on the rebel starship.
Why are you breathing so hard? So I can live. What kind of...
He looks like he thinks he's pretty cool. Superiority complex. I feel like the golden robot is really true to himself. He doesn't care if people think he's super geeky. Do robots care?
You don't know at this time, but like Darth Vader actually built that robot when he was a kid. C-3PO.
Spoiler alert.
And he doesn't go up and be like, hey man, what's up? Remember what I made you? And C-3PO doesn't understand that that's actually Anakin Skywalker, the guy that made him, his creator.
Ooh, Leia with the buns, the cinnamon buns. Iconic. What? Why do they have such a long shield on the back? It's like they all have mullets and they want to protect their head.
They look like Toadstool from Mario.
Yeah,
Toad.
Except stupider. What is that little shield part on the back of their head going to do? Why does it go down that far?
They're protecting the party in the back.
They're protecting their spinal cord. Ask any chiropractor, that's super important. Spinal column.
I was in the army. I just tell you what you got to wear. So someone said,
but
hey,
your helmets didn't go down that far. Although this was a long, long time ago, so maybe
the
they
galaxy
just
far,
know.
Far away. Ours just went like...
Maybe we're smarter.
And then went around.
Maybe our technology is better. Okay, I don't know. Okay, so they shot Princess Leia with a laser? No.
No, they can't kill her. She's a princess.
Flashback.
Set for stun.
End of flashback.
Secret mission. Plans. What are you talking about?
You don't have to repeat every line. Okay.
R2-D2 oh. and C-3PO are leaving in an escape pod because they got Leia.
Oh, they have Leia? Uh-huh. How did they get Leia?
You just said they shot her.
I thought it was the bad guys that shot her.
No, the bad guys got Leia. So she put her plans in R2-D2 and boom.
I thought that you said that they have Leia, that those two have Leia.
Mm-mm. The rebels have Leia, so that's why they took off.
Oh, they meaning the robots. Bad guys.
Ooh, so close.
See, the bad guys have Leia, see?
Yeah, she woke up quickly. She doesn't even have a helmet on. That is a good hairstyle. We used to make fun of it, but it's pretty cool, actually.
I want to know what happened to the plans they sent you.
I don't know what you're talking about.
She's playing dumb.
Holding her is dangerous. Word of this gets out. It could generate sympathy for the rebellion. She'll die before she'll tell you anything.
Darth Vader got the nerdiest assistant possible.
Battle station plans are not aboard this ship. An escape pod was jettisoned during the fighting, but no life forms were aboard.
She must have hidden the plans in the escape pod.
Hold your fire. There's no life forms.
Big mistake. Big. Huge.
So they think that the plans are just in the escape pod, but they're actually in the robots in the escape pod.
Specifically R2-D2. And the one that's guarding the plans, C-3PO, was made by Darth Vader.
We got that from earlier, thanks.
Darth Vader actually built that robot when he was a kid.
It's hard for me to watch robots walking in all the sand because, you know, when you go to the beach and you take your phone and then it gets sand in all its parts or like a camera or something. Well, we used to take cameras in the old days. It just gives me anxiety to watch robots walking on sand. I know they're getting sand in all their parts.
Getting them big cornflake boogers. Tink, tink.
What a desolate place this is. Where do you think you're going? Well, I'm not going that way. It's much too rocky. This way is much easier. What makes you think there are settlements over there? Don't get technical with me. What mission? What are you talking about? I've just about had enough of you. Go that way. You'll be malfunctioning within a day, you nearsighted scrap pile. And don't let me catch you following me, begging for help, because you won't get it. That malfunctioning little twerp. This is all his fault. He tricked me into going this way, but he'll do no better.
I like the 70s transitions. It's pretty cool. From the sand to the rocks. I'm glad the robot's not in the sand. I always get the R2-D2 and the C-3PO mixed up. Oh, there's a little guy. Which one is which? I'll have to ask Mark. He's getting the baby because we can never just watch a movie.
Those are Jawas.
Jawas?
Jawas.
Are they related to Ewoks?
No.
They have the same outfit.
They're like scavengers. They just find stuff to like sell it, and trade for it, and steal.
Which one is R2-D2 and which one's C-3PO?
R2-D2 is a little tricycle guy.
Okay, C-3PO is the color of pee. That's all. Remember that. I'm super funny. I'm super funny, guys. We've got a visitor. Oh. He wanted to be on the video, too. Whenever somebody wears a cloak like that, all you want to do is see what their face looks like. I don't know why. Like, otherwise you wouldn't care. Who cares what any of the rebels look like? Not me, but when somebody has a cloak on, you're like...
Those are just aliens. They live there. That's their planet.
Did they know those people were on that planet?
No. They just did the escape pod and they just landed the soonest place they could land.
So, like, you don't know who lives on all the planets. Like
probably not all kind of them.
I mean, I guess that's how it is. With
but this is an important planet. This is a planet where Darth Vader grew up, Luke Skywalker ended up growing up.
Of course they coincidentally landed on that planet.
Obi-Wan Kenobi's on this. Planet. And then the Mandalorian comes back later on past this. And he has to fight these same Jokers, these Jawas. Because they, you know what they do? They come rob his ship and like take all the parts out of it. I think this planet's called Tatooine. You can remember that because like you don't have any tattoos.
On my ween.
On your ween.
No. I'm not so sure you understand how to make mnemonic devices. How does remembering I don't have any tattoos help me remember this planet?
Because it's tattoo. Ween.
Yeah, but how does that relate to the planet and me? How does a tattoo relate to the planet?
If you don't have any.
Okay. It looks like there's a weird sand boat or something.
That's their vessel.
Okay.
So now the stormtroopers are down there looking for the escape pod.
Okay. They have these really advanced spaceships, but they have to ride on a weird giant lizard-looking animal.
That's a native.
Yeah, but why don't they have any spaceships down there?
You know, the other thing that's always been weird to me is, like, you can walk faster than these stupid things are riding on or walking.
Yeah, it's true. And they don't have any luggage that they're carrying. It's not like they need them for that reason.
He's got a big, heavy spear.
Looks heavy. Must be made of some sort of heavy space metal. Yeah, that guy is walking pretty slowly. Why don't they have jetpacks or something? Seems like they would have had that technology back then.
They've got speeder bikes. Well, he found a piece of a droid.
How did he know it was a piece of a droid and not just like some litter that somebody threw down? Like those little tattooinis.
Tattooinis?
Yeah. Wait, why is there a trash can walking around?
I told you it's a trash can robot.
I'm so confused.
It looks like one of those trash cans you see at a park with these big old fat legs. It was like burp, 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 burp.
Why did they put that in there?
George Lucas, man.
They're like, we need something else walking around here, but we don't have the budget. Grab that trash can. Nobody don't know the difference. Wait, now they have like a big
bowling ball droid. That's like a sprinkler.
Bomb? Oh, what is that?
A sprinkler droid. Just all kinds of stuff they're trying to sell and trade. They got C-3PO too.
Oh, they just go to little houses. Mm-hmm. Or like traveling.
Guess who that is?
I just want to see their faces.
That's Luke Skywalker. Wow. They went to his house to trade. And he doesn't know that the droid they're trading was actually made by his father, Darth Vader, when he was a kid.
It's a small world, people. It's a small world. Even
C-3PO started galaxy. Out on that planet.
The entire galaxy.
He doesn't even remember it somehow. It's a circle
kind
of
robot
life.
Is he?
He started out there, and now he's back there. It's full circle.
Yeah, but like, why doesn't he remember stuff? That's awesome. Like maybe his memory was full, okay?
You, I suppose you're programmed for etiquette and protocol.
Why, it's my primary function, sir.
I need that robot.
Can you speak bocce?
Of course I can, sir. It's like a second language to me. I'm a
all right, shut up. I'll take this.
Shutting up, sir.
Luke! Take these two over to the garage, will you? I want them cleaned up for dinner.
But I was going into Tosche Station to pick up some power converters.
You can waste time with your friends when your chores are done.
What? I want to see Luke's friends. Do they show his friends ever?
No.
Guess he doesn't ever get to waste time with his friends.
All right, come on. And the red one.
They're not taking R2-D2, and he's got the secret plan.
Oh, no.
They just shut him off. He just died.
Oh, thank heavens. Mm-hmm. That was also coincidental. Oh, they bought that one instead of the other one. Why didn't the gold one push for them to buy the other one?
He's always out for himself.
Is he?
Mm-hmm. R2, like, always wants to help other people and get into adventures. C-3PO is just a giant douche.
Why does R2-D2 like C-3PO so much?
She's nice.
I didn't know that about C-3PO.
Here, pan down to our little friend. Nice pan. So smooth. Usually.
I have a lot of skills, guys.
Reading comprehension and panning.
Connecting the dots as well.
Thank the maker. This oil bath is going to feel so good. I've got such a bad case of dust contamination, I can barely move.
I told you, dust contamination. Sand? Mm-hmm. What did I tell you? I said, don't walk in that sand,
well,
guys.
He's got it, and everybody knows when you get sand in there, it sucks.
Got something jammed in here.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope.
What's this?
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope.
Who is she? She's beautiful.
He says that he is the property of Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Obi-Wan Kenobi. I wonder if he means old Ben Kenobi. There you go. Wait a minute, where'd she go? Bring her back. Play back the entire message.
No, I don't think he likes you at all. No, I don't like you either.
C-3PO is the worst. He just told... No. Yeah.
R2-D2.
C-3PO is the worst. He just told R2-D2 he doesn't like him. Wait, I just need to see the... Oh my goodness. What is the ant wearing? Wait, is the ant wearing a denim outfit? No.
It's got a Levi's tag on it.
What?
You know, I think that R2 that we bought might have been
killed. This is a crazy movie. And also, everybody has cool haircuts, and then you pan over to the aunt. She looks like she came from the 80s grandma haircut salon. Like, what? It's not even the 80s yet. It's still the 70s when this movie was made. She came from that 70s show. She's the sister of the mom on that 70s show. Another coincidence.
He died about the same time as your father.
He knew my father?
I told you to forget it.
Luke's like the adopted kid that all of a sudden wants to know about his parents. And the uncle's like, they're all dead. They're dead.
I told you it was mean.
Ish.
He's mean. They're not all dead. Well, the mom is. But not the mean dad.
Your only concern is to prepare those new droids for tomorrow. I want them up there off the ridge working on those condensers.
I want to transmit my application to the Academy this year.
Before the harvest? Harvest is when I need you the most.
Wait, what are they harvesting? The whole thing is sand. You saw around them.
It's only one more season.
What are they harvesting?
Something that the condensers have to do.
Luke's just not a farmer, Owen.
A farmer? They live in a sand country.
They farm camels. Look, there's two suns.
Yeah, that was always cool. Although, space freaks me out. I don't know why I'm watching this.
They live in a desert inside of an igloo.
Yeah, they live in a sand igloo. And it looks way bigger on the inside than it does on the outside, doesn't it?
Well, it's like Hermione's purse.
Those suns are pretty. I like the purple sky. Nice background. Good soundtrack. I'll give him that.
He's dramatically looking off into the sunset.
He's wearing his jujitsu gi.
Thinking about how horrible his life is.
Aw, poor Luke. Aww.
Work, work, work. That's it.
Sand farmer problems, am I right?
I told him not to go, but he's 40, malfunctioning.
How could I be so stupid? He's nowhere in sight.
Oh, I missed this part. Wait, when did they say R2-D2 ran away?
Right now.
I don't blame him. The golden guy said he didn't like him. That's what happens when you're mean to people. They don't stay around. Why would they? If they're smart. Some people do.
Meanwhile, back inside the igloo.
Inside the giant igloo house that looks so little from the outside. It actually has green plants on the inside. Where are they getting that? I don't know. Do they have Amazon back then? Maybe.
She never changes. She had that on yesterday.
Oh, it's a new day? Mm-hmm. The sunset. I should know.
Oh. It's called a speeder.
Oh, there's a cool spaceship thing that hovers above the ground. That's cool.
They're going to look for R2.
Instead of riding those big lizard things, why didn't the other guys, what are those called? Get a hover racer thing.
Sand people.
There are these big yak things.
The other thing that's always weird is like the animals never correspond. I've been to the desert. You don't find animals that are built for 0 degree temperatures just roaming around in the desert. That's like a woolly mammoth in the middle of Iraq.
Yeah, but deserts can get cold.
I know, but it's hot.
You don't know the temperatures there? Although they do have two suns, so.
Now they're walking on the yak that goes like a half mile an hour.
That has giant lips. Lip filler, am I right? It's when the whole Housewives of Beverly Hills started.
They found R2-D2.
Several creatures approaching from the southeast.
Sand people.
Oh, so they're actually called sand people.
Yeah. But the sand people.
Ah! Wait, is that a mask or their actual face?
They all have that, so I don't know if they're mask or their face.
Oh, they're stealing the speeder. That's the first smart move anybody's done in this movie. Upgrade from like a yacht to a speed racer thing. I get it.
Here comes this weird guy in a robe screaming. Luke's knocked out.
Oh, I bet that's Obi-Wan Kenobi. I mean, old Ben Kenobi. Yeah, that's a human hand if I've ever seen one. And I've seen one. Yes, yes. He must be all powerful. Somehow Luke got revived. I'm not sure how.
The Force.
Apparently it was the Force.
What brings you out this far?
This little droid. Now, he claims to be the property of an Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Obi-Wan Kenobi. Now that's a name I've not heard in a long time.
Except every day when I call myself that in the mirror.
I think my uncle knows him. He said he was dead.
The uncle said he was dead. I told you his name.
Of course I...
You know him.
Well, of course I know him. He's me.
He's him. Another coincidence. Those sand people attacked them because the little robot ran away. And then old Ben just happened to show up and help. And then it just happened that Luke made the connection that he was Obi-Wan. I mean, not that hard of a connection, but still. And then I'm assuming the little robot is gonna show old Ben or Obi-Wan, whatever you want to call him, the film of Leia.
You know
that he's the only hope.
You don't know this, but
that's
like,
a lot of coincidences.
When they made the three movies before this later on, I'm pretty sure R2-D2 belonged to Obi-Wan.
Plot hole.
Lots of plot holes. That's what happens when you start the middle of a series.
I'm just saying, even if you didn't start in the middle of a series, it's like a little far-fetched.
You don't think there's a galaxy even for someplace far,
no,
far away?
No, I'm saying there could be a galaxy far, far away, whatever, whatever. That part isn't far-fetched to me. The part that's far-fetched to me...
Are the coincidences?
Is all of these coincidences.
Coincidences?
I mean, that's a lot of coincidences.
All right, let's carry on.
Where am I? I must have taken a bad step. I don't think I can make it. You go on, Master Luke. There's no sense in you risking yourself on my account. I'm done for.
Just leave him. Just leave him. Get rid of the golden robot. He's a drama queen. He's the worst. Bye. Okay, deuces.
He thought he should have stayed here and not gotten involved.
Okay, I can't understand anything Obi-Wan Kenobi says. That's it.
I was once a Jedi Knight, the same as your father.
I was a Jedi Knight, the same as your father.
He was the best star pilot in the galaxy.
He was the best star pilot in the galaxy. Ground everywhere. Whoa. I just got the sword thing. What's that called? Lightsaber.
How did my father die?
A young Jedi named Darth Vader. He betrayed and murdered your father.
Why don't they just tell him he's the dad? They're making it seem like
Yoda does eventually.
So does Darth Vader. He's like, Luke, I am your father. I think I remember hearing that line somewhere. Why don't they just say, Luke, he is your father. He didn't kill your father, he is your father. What?
Less talky-talky, more watchy-watchy.
No, Kenobi. Years ago, you served my father. Now he begs you to help him in his struggle against the Empire. I have placed information into this R2 unit.
Why didn't this movie play earlier?
Less talky-talky, more watchy-watchy.
Because he didn't when show it was him, just on a loop.
He didn't show him the whole part.
Oh, so he was hiding it?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Because it's only made for Obi-Wan Kenobi's eyes. It's secret.
Oh.
Like, when they split these twins up, Luke went to the uncle, and Leia went to a guy who was, like, a high politician. That's why she's a princess.
Why'd they split them up?
Because they wanted to keep them separate, because they thought Darth Vader was going to come for him and train him to be evil Jedis. And so they were like told, don't ever let them know that Darth Vader's their dad.
How do you know all that stuff?
Because you learn this in the three movies before this, which are after the three movies.
So there's no way you would know this just watching the movie.
No, you would not. So if you didn't know all the other back stuff, you're not even filming me. You're filming the stack of pillows.
Oops.
Now you're getting this both.
What? Oh, the stack of pillows counts as a person.
It's the leaning tower of pillows. But okay. Anyhow, yeah, you wouldn't know that.
But why did you even tell me that now?
Because it was kind of a little bit of an answer why they don't say anything about Darth Vader being his father. It's because they think they're protecting him.
Oh, because they think they'll want to go to their father and then become evil. Mm-hmm. Okay, that makes sense.
You must learn the ways of the Force.
I'm not going to Alderaan.
I need your help, Luke. I'm getting too old for this sort of thing.
Coincidentally, Obi-Wan is getting too old for this sort of thing, and he needs Luke's help. It seems like it took Darth Vader a long time to actually go talk to Leia.
And now, Your Highness.
He just called his daughter Your Highness.
That is weird. Does he know she's his daughter?
Oh.
No. Wait, is it Darth Vader Skywalker? Is that his name? Oh, Anakin. Okay. Nobody knows her last name, apparently. She doesn't even know her last name, although Luke knows his last name.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, did they say his last name at the beginning? Or, like, did he say I'm Luke Skywalker? Mm-hmm. Or just Luke?
Skywalker. Her last name isn't Skywalker.
Oh, okay.
She got raised by a different
Maybe that's family. Not even a last name. Maybe it's just, like, a name.
It's not his name.
No, because Anakin Skywalker.
You learned this from the earlier movies. He knew that Padme, they weren't married, because as a Jedi, you can't get married. Like priests. But he knocked her up anyway, and then he thought he killed her, because he got really mad
Wait,
at her.
Wait, I feel like you shouldn't be explaining this in the first movie.
Okay, just trying to further complicate it.
Oh. There's some weird ball thing. Oh, with a shot. They couldn't have just gotten a human to do that.
There's nothing you could have done. You'd have been killed, too. The droids would now be in the hands of the Empire.
Coincidentally, Luke wasn't at the sand igloo when the stormtroopers traced the robots back home, so he wasn't killed.
I want to come with you to Alderaan. There's nothing for me here now. I want to learn the ways of the Force and become a Jedi like my father.
But now, because there's nothing for him there anymore, he says he wants to learn the Force and become a Jedi.
Coincidentally, I mean, I feel like he always wanted to. His uncle was just holding him down, you know what I'm saying? Space rat. Where are they going?
To Alderaan to take the secret plans there.
I never realized they had that little space racer thing in the first one. I thought that was just like a new or...
No, those new movies came before these.
I get it. I get that, but like...
There was a gala.
Okay.
Again, riding a super huge thing that doesn't walk fast.
And then there's a space racer going through, like hovering. Like, why doesn't everybody get a space racer? Are they really expensive? Because the sand farmer didn't seem like he made that much money. But apparently he can afford a space racer.
Hey,
I don't get that.
You don't need to see his identification.
Huh?
You don't need to understand what's going on in this movie.
Hold on.
You don't need to understand what's going on in this movie.
It's all so clear now.
Let me see your identification.
You don't need to see his identification.
We don't need to see his identification.
These aren't the droids you're looking for.
These aren't the droids we're looking for.
Move along.
If it's that easy to just use the Force and mind control, why don't they do that with the whole Empire, evil Empire?
Because it only works on the weak-minded.
So definitely on me. Okay.
I can't understand how we got by those troops. I thought we were dead.
Luke didn't understand it either. I just should have kept watching the movie. Lesson learned. Probably not, but maybe.
The Force can have a strong influence on the weak-minded.
Do you really think we're gonna find a pilot here that'll take us to Alderaan?
Most of the best freighter pilots will be found here.
Most of the best pilots can be found in Mos Eisley. But like, there are zero spaceships around, just people riding big giant animals that walk slowly. And Obi-Wan already said it was like a filth scum bag hole or something mean like that. But all the best pilots are there. Okay. Well, one of them is a bat, so... Okay. Wrinkle cream, have you heard of it?
Hey, we don't serve their kind here.
What?
You're a droid. They'll have to wait outside. We don't want them here.
Ooh, snap. Racist against droids. Okay. I see you, Star Wars. I don't know what that means. That guy that just turned around and handed him like a drink or something, he looks like a villager from Minecraft. In real life. There's a giant tongue! A giant tongue! Ugh, Chewbacca, I hate him so much.
That's balls for you. That's nose.
He doesn't like you.
Well, I don't like him, okay? Nobody cares if you like me or not like me. Oh. He dropped his
arm off.
He dropped his arm off. I was not expecting his arm to be hairy. With like a claw. And everybody's just like, okay. What happened to the guy? Where is he? Where'd he go?
He's like cowering in a corner with one arm off.
Did I miss it?
Now he's like one arm nose.
I didn't expect the crazy nose guy that was mad at Luke to have a hairy claw arm.
Did you expect the nose that he would have? That was like...
No, but like his whole head was bald and then he had a hairy claw arm.
Hey, if you watch the credits, his name at the end is Schnaz.
I think I've heard of him before. He got really famous after this movie. They couldn't have made any aliens cute on this movie. Like, the aliens hurt my eyes, man.
What about Chewie?
No, he's not even cute. He looks crazy. And he is the most annoying. He's like, rah, the whole movie. Who wants to hear that? Not me. I am Groot. Now that's a language I can get on board with. The good news is Han already has the rebel suit on. He just needs to get a hat because he already has the black vest and 70s big collar shirt. So that'll be an expense that they don't have to pay. Chewbacca is the guy that started the whole hair feathering trend, pretty sure.
You think I had a choice?
Over my dead body.
Oh.
Just got shot and your giant tongue was like, what the?
Oldest trick in the book. I guess in this bar it's like fine to just chop people's arms off and kill people.
They said
like,
it's pretty rough.
Sorry about the mess.
Then he just tossed a stone at the bartender.
No, that was money.
Now the bartender's like, man, I have to clean up this body. Like, you know how bad this smells? Make it old. Maybe he'll just make it into a stew and serve it to everybody. Who knows? What's that one movie called? I can't remember. Where they make the guy into a stew. Steel Magnolias? No. He's just gonna Tuwanda that guy. Oh, here's a guy that looks like a giant bird following them. Ew. Okay, Jabba the Hutt is a giant slug, which is a horrible villain. If you've ever gotten slug slime on your hand, it's gross. Although slugs are way cuter than Jabba, and they don't have arms. They just have those little antennae that poke out. Ew. I didn't know he had a tail like that. Harrison Ford is really getting into this acting with Jabba, honestly. It makes me feel as if Jabba's actually there. Even I get bored sometimes. Oh, he stepped over his tail. He's really getting up close to Jabba. It kind of bugs me that Jabba's nose holes are crooked. I guess we can't all be perfect.
Jabba, you're a wonderful human being.
You're a wonderful human being? He's not a human being.
He's making fun of it. Look, there's Boba Fett.
I don't know who Boba Fett is.
The Mandalorian gear.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that's who you were talking about. They call him Mando in the movie.
That's not Boba Fett. You haven't watched all Mandalorian at the end?
I've watched none of Mandalorian.
Oh, okay. Well,
I saw Luke at the end taking a baby Yoda away. That's it.
Well, it's cool once you, like, you'll see Boba Fett in these ones, and then Mandalorian comes after the end of these ones before the next movies
come. Is Boba Fett an actual person that plays a part in these movies?
Slightly, yeah. Okay. He's a bad guy.
He's a bad guy?
He's not Imperial, but he's still kind of bad.
Like a Han Solo type criminal, or like a...
Yeah, they're probably on the same level. He's a bounty hunter, and Han Solo is a smuggler. Like, they're both trying to outrun all the law. They're against the Empire, but they're like...
That one couple in the background just looks like a normal couple. Mm-hmm.
If the ship's as fast as he's boasting, we ought to do well.
Oh, there's an elephant alien. Oh, that was the bird guy. I thought he looked like a bird from the front, but he actually looks more like an elephant from the side.
He's snitching on him.
What a piece of junk!
Luke has a way with words. A little rush,
you'll just get on. She'll make 0.5 past light speed. She may not look like much, but she's got it where it counts, kid. I've made a lot of special modifications myself.
He's like a bootlegger. He's got a junky old truck with a blown, like, 460 under the hood that you can't tell.
A blown 460 means a good engine, I guess. Just clarifying. Oh, there are beggars, the Monster Wars. Okay, well, I guess it was a long, long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, so...
Which way?
Stop that ship! Okay, somehow all the bullets, all the laser beam bullet things are missing everybody, like always. Somehow they killed all the rebels, and the rebels didn't kill any of them. Probably because they had better suits, honestly. But how do they keep missing everybody? Oh, they're flying away.
What you're forgetting is this was like Avatar in the late 70s, mm-hmm. special effects wise, so the plot holes weren't even like, nobody cared. You're just like, man, have you seen this really cool movie? The special effects were crazy. Mm-hmm. It went crazy.
Ooh, somebody dressed up in a dog suit and went rawr. I don't know. If I were in the 70s, I would be like, why are the laser beams not hitting anybody? Are they actual weapons? Are they just things that shoot out and go through people and don't do any harm? What was happening?
It's right a now? Laser. Laser.
Han's just standing there like...
Stay sharp. There's two more coming in. They're going to try and cut us off.
We'll be safe enough once we make the jump to hyperspace.
What's hyperspace?
Light speed.
Oh, so hyperspace and light speed are the same thing. They expect you to know that somehow.
Right there, Gating?
Luke thought this thing was fast.
I thought you said this thing was fast.
Traveling through hyperspacing like dust and crop. Without precise calculations, we'd fly right through a star or bounce too close to a supernova.
Going light speed takes a lot of skill, is what I'm saying. Even though supposedly your electrons or something would be going through
there it.
Your atoms would be going so fast at light speed that you would explode, but whatever, whatever. Is that Earth?
Alderaan.
Oh, okay.
That's where Leia was headed. And I think that's where they're headed, too.
Governor Tuck, I should have expected to find you holding Vader's leash.
Ooh, Leia's sassy.
You don't know how hard I found it, signing the order to terminate your life.
Ew, don't touch my face. They have weird accents. I guess Great Britain must have been a thing back then. This guy sounds kind of British.
No, Alderaan is peace, but we have no weapons. You can't
Leia definitely has like a unique accent.
The more you tighten your grip, Tuck.
Probably one of those accents that used to be in a galaxy a long time ago and far, far away.
You see, Lord Vader, she can be reasonable.
So Darth Vader doesn't know she's the daughter. Does he even know he had kids?
No.
It doesn't matter.
You may fire when ready.
What?
An entire planet. Oh, did not see that one coming. Seems like the Death Star is fully functioning.
Are you alright? What's wrong?
I felt a great disturbance in the Force.
Oh, my goodness. I thought it was a heart attack. Okay, Luke's playing some sort of game with a flying ball. Chewie and the Golden Robot are playing a game too. I think Kai would like that game.
It's like Alien Checkers.
Oh, okay.
He made a fair move. Screaming about it can't help you.
Chewie is so annoying.
It's because a droid don't pull people's arms out of their sockets when they lose.
All of a sudden, Harrison Ford doesn't use good grammar. I think he's trying to be tough. Okay, Luke's still doing the ball thing. All inside of a spaceship. It's like shooting. Good thing they brought travel games. You know what I'm saying?